You see a police cruiser finally getting ahead of this car, and there's
also
another
behind.
One behind, so it looks like they might be boxing this car in. Rod?
Yeah, the car behind it, that looks like Texas Highway Patrol. They may be better equipped to handle the pursuit. They may even be using or taught how to use the pit maneuver. It looks like the speeds had dropped down. Cars were passing it, but now it looks like the speeds are picking up again. There you can see the Highway Patrol car. That looks like a local agency, maybe the Harris County Sheriff or the Houston PD. It looks like they may try this box maneuver again.
Well, they're definitely picking up speed. As you can see on the left-hand side, there's a concrete barrier there, pretty congested through this area that the police have now chosen to try and get up on the driver.
But it looks like that BMW has passed that cruiser that was in front of it once again. So now we see a couple of cruisers again behind him. But this suspect is the lead car once again.
And again, you can see that he's really picking up speed. What's happening is a lot of communication between the different agencies and supervisors and perhaps even the brass at the departments involved in this on what they should do next. It looked like they maybe were in a position that they were going to try and force him into the K-rail, and they opted not to do that because of the speeds. Look at the
looks like the going. Guy with the truck, the utilities truck, is actually trying to keep up with the BMW, maybe even try and help out police, because here he comes up on the side of the vehicle and he's going to maybe take a swipe at it.
Well, incredibly dangerous.
Yeah.
Absolutely incredibly dangerous, and all that does is makes it much, much more difficult for the police to do their job, because now they have to worry about innocent people getting involved in this thing. The fact that they have the Highway Patrol behind them is pretty good, because the Highway Patrol officers, obviously, this is their beat. They drive high speeds and they drive on the freeways.
We just saw that truck slow down fairly quickly there,
also,
and now you
and
see this car just swerving and almost hitting.
But behind the cruiser and in between that truck, that utility vehicle. Yeah, I guess the utility truck is probably going to learn from the cops now that he needs to back off and not be involved in this, because they know exactly what they're doing and don't want to make this more of a skittish situation.
Yeah, there's a backup unit that's going to pull that guy over and read him the Riot Act and just let him know how much difficulty, how much more difficult his intervening in this thing makes it on the officers. Now, there is a Texas State Highway Patrol officer there. Pulling up on the side of the car.
Right. Rod, why are they not flashing their lights, which would give a warning at least to other drivers on the road?
It's a little difficult to see, but my guess is that they do have their overhead lights on and they do have their sirens operating. That's the law in California when you're conducting these pursuits. They're probably doing the same thing there. It's just a little difficult to see.
Okay.
But at these speeds, let me remind you guys, at these speeds, you can't hear that siren. That siren is almost completely ineffective. Again, you can see that high-performance BMW. He is really
picking
now.
Up speed, absolutely. And they just headed through an area on 59, back through Sugarland, an area of Houston, roughly going about 100 miles an hour, as we understand it. But they were coming up on the Beltway, which would have given him more options, again, to take different routes, to confuse police once again.
Right, and we want to catch any viewers who are just popping in now up to what we're following here. It's a developing story out of the Houston area where this possibly stolen BMW has led police on a chase for nearly 2 hours now. The suspect inside, we just got word that this is not a stolen vehicle, but this is a suspect wanted in an assault case, potentially.
Local affiliates there had talked to police saying that this could stem from some type of domestic assault situation. Again, as Sophia was mentioning, we've been learning about this has been going on for roughly 2 hours. Our coverage roughly began 45, 50 minutes ago, but it's been a wild one to watch because this driver has taken police on a real wild chase around the Houston area, making lots of U-turns, getting on different interstates and highways, and using it all to his advantage to try and stay one step ahead of all the police that are involved. The Houston Police Department is involved. Also, the Harris County Sheriff's Department was involved. Now, as we understand it, the Houston PD is the lead in the pursuit on this, but they have dropped back. We were watching moments ago how two cruisers were trying to come up on this vehicle, potentially box it in, but then they let go. And here we go one more time,
right,
seeing maybe the Texas State
Patrol
coming up.
the Highway Patrol also involved in this chase, and we've seen them try to use this box maneuver a couple of times, and it hadn't worked so far. We've seen them come awfully close to this vehicle, officers come awfully close to this vehicle, and somehow the suspect has maneuvered around them and gotten in front of them.
Rod Burnson's on the phone with us. He's a former LAPD sergeant. Wealth of information, Rod. Again, we appreciate you taking time to join us. And as you're watching now, the speed's picking up. He's using the shoulder of the road to get around cars that are getting in his way. And obviously, it looks like it's getting a little more congested.
Well, one of the things, driving on the shoulder like that, he's likely to pick up some debris that may flatten one or more of his tires. You said something that I have to key on, and that is involved in a domestic situation. The leading cause of officers killed or seriously injured in the United States as a result of responding to domestic violence calls. You wouldn't think that a family dispute would be the leading cause, but in fact it is. So the officers have to factor that in. But if in fact they know who the suspect is, that's going to, again, give them much more information on who he is, why he is running like this. Mm-hmm. Is he wanted in other crimes? Is he a possible second or third striker? Is he looking at a long stretch in prison? So there's a whole number of factors that just all that does is help the officers when they try to manage this pursuit.
And Rod, correct me if I'm wrong, but police have to go ahead and assume that he is armed.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. In this situation, this is not the act of a rational human being. And so you always anticipate the absolute worst, that the suspect is armed and is willing to shoot it out with you. Clearly, he's demonstrated no regard for innocent people. Look how fast he's driving.
Armed with this vehicle.
The number of close calls he's had.
Right. We're just getting word that this vehicle is now in the area of the Galleria area of Houston. But this suspect has taken officers on all sorts of freeways in all sorts of areas, and this has been going on for nearly 2 hours now at high speeds at times and slow speeds at times, and somehow the suspect continues to get away.
One thing, Rod, we haven't seen is the fact that the police departments haven't coordinated, at least for one highway or two highways, some type, of trap plan where they haven't let people on the on-ramps or tried to block it in some fashion so that they could have control of one area, say he chooses to go that way.
Well, what I thought was interesting is that there doesn't appear to be an attempt to keep the cars back behind the pursuit, that the they seem to not have a problem with these innocent people coming up on the pursuit. In California, they'll do what's called a rolling roadblock to try and keep innocent people from coming up on the pursuit. They're not doing that. And also, they don't appear to be leaping out in front of the pursuit and trying to block the on-ramps to keep the volume of traffic down.
And we've seen the danger of that, Rod, in a couple of instances where civilians have tried to get involved in this pursuit.
Yeah, and all that really does is just make it very, very difficult for the police. They know what they're doing. They're trained to handle this. They're the ones that are able to drive at the high speeds, anticipating what the suspect is doing or is going to do. Innocent people thinking they're going to help the police, all they're doing is just making it much, much worse.
And clearly, because this isn't a stolen vehicle, he's much more comfortable, in that car the suspect is, and knows how far to push the vehicle.
Yeah, but again, you're dealing with somebody who's not very rational at this point, trying to run from the police. It's so problematic for the police because their first concern is innocent people and making sure that innocent people aren't become involved in this thing. And then secondarily, trying to get this guy to stop. Notice, see how he's moving around inside the car like that?
Yeah.
That information is going to be relayed from the choppers. They'll have a much tighter camera shot or probably fly lower. They're going to pass that information along to let the officers know this guy is really moving around.
Right, and we don't know what he's reaching for. It could be
exactly
a weapon. It could be, a bottle of water. Who
exactly
knows?
It could be as simple as a cell phone. Authorities, though, we're being told, are trying to get enforced vehicles on the road that have better bumpers. And, Rob, what does that say to you? They're trying to put together some type of pit maneuver.
Well, it's entirely possible, yeah. The Highway Patrol cars, they have those push bumpers, so they're...
Ooh, we just saw him get nicked on the tail there, and he's actually making a U-turn,
going the wrong way
on the freeway now.
This isn't good. Now, you see, this is exactly why they have to take this guy out as soon as humanly possible.
Okay. Looks like there's going to be a problem here, guys, because he's going the wrong way, and there's going to be a call.
There's the crash. He stopped now, and here's this other person,
this person's
going right up
to the vehicle because she doesn't realize what's going on. That this
is and banging on the suspect's window. Oh, no, she needs to get out of there.
Yeah, here come the police, though. They're right on the tail of this to figure out exactly what's going on. The guy's trying to get out of his sunroof right now. His arms are up in the air.
This may come to a peaceful end. She's
absolutely very upset about this because she ran straight to the back of her car. I think there may be somebody in the back seat she was worried about. Police have their guns drawn. The man is climbing out, getting down on the ground as we see right now, arms behind his back.
So this looks like it's coming to a peaceful end after a very dangerous 2 hours in very high speeds involved in this chase. But looks like
they're getting the guy up now. They're dragging him to the back of this police cruiser to put him away. We're not going to take a break, folks. We're going to keep you with this. To watch this unfold, but this has been one incredible story to witness this afternoon, a developing story out of Houston, a car chase that's gone on for 2 hours with this guy that's just really no regard for anybody that were on the roads today.
No, I mean, we've seen him come close to coming into multiple accidents before, really at high speeds, maneuvering in tricky positions, and here it came to an end because he got bumped on the tail, had to go the wrong way on the freeway, and then smashed right into a car there, looked like kind of on an off-ramp.
Rob, what was absolutely incredible, though, was to watch the person in the other vehicle have such concern for this guy by jumping out of their vehicle to run over and make sure that the guy was okay and try and figure out, you know, what's going on. Is this man hurt?
You know, what's remarkable is look at this post-pursuit discipline. There was only one officer that handcuffed this guy, and all the other officers went to the car, the innocent person there.
There's a car seat in the back.
They're
pulling a baby out.
No
wonder the woman who jumped out was so upset because she ran straight to the back, concerned for the child that's in that car seat.
Well, fortunately, she has airbags, and the child was in the car seat and strapped in. It looks the baby's moving. So the baby appears to be okay. The woman appears to be okay.
Yeah.
Beyond just an emotional wreck at this point.
That poor lady just seems so rattled. Your heart breaks.
Can you imagine? Up to a scene like that.
You have to compliment this department that was involved in this because of their post-pursuit discipline. We've seen other cases that came to an end, and there was just a bunch of officers that jumped on the suspect. Not in this case. They showed tremendous discipline in how they conducted the pursuit. And the officers were more concerned about the people in that car than they were the suspect. Once they had them in handcuffs,
Let's give everybody an idea, Rod, real quickly. This is Highway 59, the Greenbrier area, southwest Houston area. And it looks like the police are actually trying to go through the vehicle. Potentially, maybe there's more people
children.
Inside.
Maybe more children in the car. I mean, this is just so lucky that no one was killed because he was going at such a high speed.
In the wrong direction. Into oncoming traffic. Some cars did get out of his way, though, as we watched. There were about two vehicles that he was able to speed past. This four-door vehicle, as you see, not so lucky. They collided the driver's side fronts, both vehicles, which then pinned the car, as you're seeing, against the barrier right there, also wedging the BMW that was in the high-speed chase up against the other side. The woman behind the wheel of the four-door car jumped out to try and help the guy that was wanted by police.
And also check on her own child who was in a car seat, and it looks like that baby is going to be okay, and we're going to stick with this to find out if there's anyone else in that that car that was hit by this suspect. And we have to say the suspect did get out of the car, hands up, didn't see a weapon, laid down on the ground, and he has been arrested. Rod, what kind of charges does this guy face now?
Well, I'm not sure about the state of Texas.
You see a police cruiser finally getting ahead of this car, and there's
also
another
behind.
One behind, so it looks like they might be boxing this car in. Rod?
Yeah, the car behind it, that looks like Texas Highway Patrol. They may be better equipped to handle the pursuit. They may even be using or taught how to use the pit maneuver. It looks like the speeds had dropped down. Cars were passing it, but now it looks like the speeds are picking up again. There you can see the Highway Patrol car. That looks like a local agency, maybe the Harris County Sheriff or the Houston PD. It looks like they may try this box maneuver again.
Well, they're definitely picking up speed. As you can see on the left-hand side, there's a concrete barrier there, pretty congested through this area that the police have now chosen to try and get up on the driver.
But it looks like that BMW has passed that cruiser that was in front of it once again. So now we see a couple of cruisers again behind him. But the suspect is the lead car once again.
And again, you can see that he's really picking up speed. What's happening is a lot of communication between the different agencies and supervisors and perhaps even the brass at the departments involved in this on what they should do next. It looked like they maybe were in a position that they were going to try and force him into the K-rail, and they opted not to do that because of the speeds. Look at the
looks
speeds
like the guy with the truck, the utilities truck, is actually trying to keep up with the BMW, maybe even try and help out police, because here he comes up on the side of the vehicle and he's going to maybe take a swipe at it.
Well, incredibly dangerous.
Yeah.
Absolutely incredibly dangerous. And all that does is makes it much, much more difficult for the police to do their job, because now they have to worry about innocent people getting involved in this thing. The fact that they have the Highway Patrol behind them is pretty good, because the Highway Patrol officers, obviously, this is their beat. They drive high speeds and they drive on the freeways.
We just saw that truck slow down fairly quickly there.
Also,
and now you
and
see this car just swerving and almost hitting.
But behind the cruiser and in between that truck, that utility vehicle. Yeah, I guess the utility truck is probably going to learn from the cops now that he needs to back off and not be involved in this, because they know exactly what they're doing and don't want to make this more of a skittish situation.
Yeah, there's a backup unit that's going to pull that guy over and read him the Riot Act and just let him know how much difficulty, how much more difficult his intervening in this thing makes it on the officers. Now, there is a Texas Highway, State Highway Patrol officer there. Pulling up on the side of the car.
Right, Rod, why are they not flashing their lights, which would give a warning at least to other drivers on the road?
It's a little difficult to see, but my guess is that they do have their overhead lights on and they do have their sirens operating. That's the law in California when you're conducting these pursuits. They're probably doing the same thing there. It's just a little difficult to see.
Okay.
But at these speeds, let me remind you guys, at these speeds, you can't hear that siren. That siren is almost completely ineffective. Again, you can see that high-performance BMW. He is really, really moving
really picking
now.
Up speed, absolutely. And they just headed through an area on 59, back through Sugarland, an area of Houston, roughly going about 100 miles an hour, as we understand it. But they were coming up on the Beltway, which would have given him more options, again, to take different routes, to confuse police once again.
Right, and we want to catch any viewers who are just popping in now up to what we're following here. It's a developing story out of the Houston area where this possibly stolen BMW has led police on a chase for nearly 2 hours now. The suspect inside, we just got word that this is
not a stolen vehicle.
But this is a suspect wanted in an assault case, potentially.
Local affiliates there had talked to police saying that this could stem from some type of domestic assault situation. Again, as Sophia was mentioning, we've been learning about this. Has been going on for roughly 2 hours. Our coverage roughly began.